when I run into people sometimes in airports and they ask me what I'm working on, and I tell them I'm working on commercial crew, and they're like, oh, we're going to commercialize our astronauts? And I have to explain, no, it's not about commercial crew. It's about a commercial transportation system to get NASA crew members to and from the International Space Station. We're doing it a little bit differently than a traditional NASA program because we're trying to develop systems that can not only NASA can use to transport our astronauts to the ISS, but also the commercial industry can use for other customers. We are investing with multiple companies, letting them know what our needs are for the ultimate services phase, where they are providing transportation to ISS, but we're allowing them a little bit more flexibility to develop the systems. We're assisting them where we can, and ultimately we'll be approving and verifying the fact that their systems meet our safety and mission requirements. So at the end, it's not that much different, but in the beginning, it's quite different. I look at the investment that we've made on the space station program, and that investment has been very significant in terms of, if you go back to all the money that we've invested, the shuttle flights to assemble, and we're right at the point in space station where we're starting to reap the benefits, the scientific benefits of that investment. In order to maintain people on orbit, you need to do that science. You need to be able to supply them with cargo, and you need to be able to swap them out periodically. Right now, as a partnership, we have one way to get humans up and down, and that is the Soyuz, the Russian Soyuz system. So we are single string on getting people up and down. I think the real need is to have at least some redundancy in our capability to get people up and down to ISS, and the commercial crew program is going to provide that redundancy. So we will have both Soyuz and a U.S. system, at least one, that can do that. If we're going to be a species who robustly explores space, in order to do it cost effectively, there's got to be an economic incentive that comes along with it. So NASA can stretch the frontier, but the money that's required to do that is going to be difficult to sustain any type of exploration of that frontier, and that's going to have to come from what I believe it has to really drive from a commercial economic type of engine, and I think the commercial crew program and the commercial cargo program are really the first steps in trying to make that happen. My hope is that, if the commercial spaceflight industry does flourish and other markets emerge for these for transportation to low Earth orbit, human transportation, that more and more individuals, more and more people will have the opportunity to fly in space. And I know initially it'll be very expensive, and so that market will be very limited, but it is such an amazing experience that, in my view, that a commercial industry that ultimately has other customers and other reasons to fly to low Earth orbit, I think it's really exciting. And I think not just school kids, but I think Americans in general get excited by that opportunity, that someday, maybe not for them, but maybe their kids or their grandkids, even if they don't want to become an astronaut, might have the opportunity to, a professional astronaut might have an opportunity to fly in space someday.